Welcome back everyone to the live CUBE coverage here in Washington DC for Google Next 2025. I'm John Furrier, host. Bob Laliberte, analyst at theCUBE. Welcome back everyone.
Good to be here.
Nutanix.
Okay. We were just talking about it.
Next. Hold on. Nutanix Next. Bob's like, should we cut? No, we're live.
We're live.
I love live television. Google Next and Nutanix launched. Yeah, the Next. Nutanix Next.
Okay. The Nexus.
Welcome back to the Next. So seriously, Nutanix Next 2025, Google Next 2025 just happened a couple weeks ago. You guys had a preview. Michael from Nutanix, thanks for coming on. Kelly from Google.
Okay. Great to be here.
Glad to be here as well.
All right, so you just saw that failed intro. Let's get into, I got thick skin, I've done so many interviews, I can handle it. The Nutanix Cloud solution, obviously multi-cloud is a big part of the strategy.
Correct.
You guys had a huge, successful Google Next. What is the preview? Talk about the relationship between Google and Nutanix.
Yeah, so the relationship is actually quite new. We just embarked on a partnership jointly together. Google announced recently, but I think it was about last year, about preview for their bare metal service. So Kelly, maybe you can touch upon a little bit more what that is. And then, of course, we were very excited about that announcement, given that, you know, Nutanix is all about offering customers choice and running their workloads wherever they want them to run. And so hearing that Google's providing a bare metal service, and we're able to take advantage of that, extend our cloud cluster solution to that, and provide customers more choice and which hyperscale they want to work with. Kelly, maybe I'll let you kind of touch upon a little bit more what the launch is exactly, and I can also talk about what we're doing there.
Yeah, I would say it's interesting during the keynote, one thing that really stood out to me was choice and optionality. And so I think going into this partnership that we've been working on kind of behind the scenes for the last year or so, customers are looking for alternatives to VMware. And they're looking for alternatives to, you know, kind of take that journey to the cloud. And I think this bare metal solution and NC2 on GCP will be part of that journey. Like, a lot of customers aren't ready to move hundreds, if not thousands, of apps right away. So taking, you know, this partnership to the next level. We're the third hyperscaler, third but not, you know, not least. So we're
absolutely
excited
not
to kind of take those learnings.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
You know, we're here, you know, the next several days with our PM team and our go-to-market team to talk to joint customers. We did a lot of that at Google Next. And so just trying to glean more of the use cases and, you know, set the stage and tone for, you know, what workloads we can support in the long term, not just on Z3.
Yeah, and one of the things that the theme here at Nutanix Next 2025 is the platform conversation, and key to that is run anywhere, build once, run anywhere. So multi-cloud, super cloud, what would we call super cloud, but multi-cloud, that's a key criteria, and not just from a VMware perspective to the cloud, other workloads.
Yes.
That was a big theme at Google Next 2025, where you're starting to see that distributed computing architecture. That's a big part of Rajiv's talk.
Correct.
The containers, the cloud native. How does this fit in? What were some of the preview highlights? Where are you in the status of it? How do people get involved? What are some of the mechanics of the relationship? Can you share that?
Yeah, absolutely. Happy to do so. So when we talk to customers, right, it's a pretty common theme that we hear, which is, I have obviously an existing infrastructure. Very, very few times do we run into a customer say I have nothing. Because it's like, well, then you have a lot of freedom of choice.
You have needs.
So you're starting from usually, and it's usually tends to be a VM, VM-based workloads on premises, right? And then the question is like, okay, what's that single platform that allows me to modernize and then accelerate, rapidly accelerate, right? But the first kind of starting point is where we hear is like, it's that migration piece, right? So let's say I want to take advantage of Google's latest innovations with AI in the cloud. Well, I can't do that if I can't get to the cloud, right?
Yeah.
Or if I spend 5 years trying to migrate to the cloud, right? That's a long time before I can innovate, and that's just not acceptable for our customers. So that's why we always talk about modernization. How do we help customers get to, let's say in this case, Google Cloud, leverage the latest and greatest services to evolve their applications, but it starts with migration, right? And this is kind of where Nutanix Cloud Clusters and our relationship starts with. So a lot of the early conversations with customers are, how do we help them migrate to the cloud?
Is there a requirement, and I know it's private previous, this is a sign-up process, so
correct.
Is it open to everyone, or you guys have a filtered criteria? What are some of the requirements requirements on this preview?
So our criteria is actually pretty
broad.
So reach out to your Google rep or your Nutanix rep, show your interest, and then we'll evaluate kind of based on the scenarios and workloads that you're trying to enable. We'll see if we can support those. But we're pretty quickly moving to public preview, right? So Rajiv in our keynote earlier mentioned that this is coming late 2025. So we're planning next few months open it up to public preview where anyone can go start trying out the service here.
I'd say some of the lower hanging fruit are, we're in regions where a lot of hyperscalers are not, like KSA. So I would say there's kind of gravitational pull to folks who are looking to get into those regions. But also, like, we're not going to get away without talking about AI and the advent of AI. It's super interesting. I manage a team of ISVs. There's some model LLM builders in that classification of customers, and it's super interesting because customers have data on-prem, they're using Google for training, and they might be using AWS for inferencing.
Yep.
And I think this is an opportunity for Nutanix to kind of be that management layer. They have the prowess with the management aspect of it, the simplicity, and then we've got the robust infrastructure and of course the AI innovation to kind of enable and accelerate those AI workloads.
Well, and the compute power, because the biggest problem with AI is on-premises. It's really hard to get sufficient compute power, and of course storage capacity, electricity and so forth, so that's an ideal use case for the public cloud, right?
Yeah, absolutely, and one of your other announcements at Google Next was the fact that you developed the Cloud WAN networking environment, which is going to enable organizations that are globally enabling them to get and leverage that backbone, so a high performance network to connect up all of their devices. So if you're on that cloud, right, if you're at a remote location, being able to leverage that to move your traffic around and being able to keep everything
connected.
And
you actually bring up a really good point, and it comes to really how we are developing the solution, Nutanix Cloud Clusters with Google, and how we deploy it, which is, this is a solution that is actually fully deployed and managed within the customer tenant, right? So that means whatever the private networking that you have set up across your on-premises edge in a public cloud can easily apply to this solution. When you think about, hey, how do I take the solution now and extend to additional cloud native services within Google, right? And how do I now make sure I govern that and operate that in a single system matter? It's really rapidly, you can apply kind of everything that you have and everything you're leveraging from Google or you have already in place, right? So that's actually a very unique thing that actually applies to Nutanix Cloud Clusters that we haven't at least seen anywhere else from
other
vendors.
What's the big storyline on this deal for people that just learning about the relationship? Obviously the platform, we heard the news today from Rajiv. What's this joint story? What's the relationship like? What's next? What are you working on? Besides getting the public preview out, public version, as fast as possible.
Yeah, so I think, I think that the big story is now we're enabling you optionality, right, with Google Cloud. We know we've seen actually a lot of demand. We actually have already our first few public preview, or I should say private preview customers deploying and trying out the solution. We see the demand, the list of people signing up for preview just growing rapidly, so we know the demand is there. We know that customers obviously wanted this solution. They, there's a set of customers that are taking a big bet with Google Cloud, so there was this huge demand, pent-up demand for making sure that we're offering that. So I think the biggest news is that, hey, we've enabled kind of your ability to migrate, modernize with Google Cloud and get going, right? And I think the next kind of step is look forward to seeing more unique offerings, product offerings from us. So things like getting smart around your TCO as you think about the public cloud. So things like, for example, naturally, like backup restore, right? That's a great cloud story because you can go and put your backups up in Google Cloud Storage, right? And then let's say a disaster happens, you can quickly hydrate that cluster. Well, that might end up happening in Google Cloud, right?
Right.
So look for more unique cases that we're going to jointly develop that just help improve your TCO and really allow you to get very intelligent with your workload placement, right?
Yeah, and is a lot of this being driven by organizations looking to modernize, get off of VMs, move to Kubernetes, right?
Correct, and then that creates a new challenge, right? Because now you have, okay, well, I have VMs, I have Kubernetes, I don't want to go train my people in three different things to manage one environment, right? So again, as you guys heard with Rajiv in the keynote, right, it's all about that single consistent platform to build, operate, and also govern, right? Making sure I'm not exposing my surface area to attack.
And migrate. I thought the Nutanix move was a really compelling piece of that, right? And accelerating those moves as well.
Yeah, I think moves going to be consistent a hit for customers kind of with that step zero. Yeah. I suspect that a lot of folks will also leverage that too with Google Cloud and Nutanix.
I mean, Google Cloud has taken advantage of all the AI. In fact, they have the same DNA that Nutanix has. They think about AI for their products, inside to make it better, how do they use it in the market, and how customers use it, kind of the three kind of priorities that was laid out earlier in theCUBE. The thing about the AI is abstract away all that integration layers. So migration used to be a pain in the butt, if you go back a few years. Grinding out, very brittle.
Yeah.
Correct.
I'm not saying you pave it over with AI, but AI kind of puts it's like the bricks, mortar between the bricks, and helps people. You guys have had great success with that. This is a perfect storm for what used to be hard.
Yeah. It's still hard, right? But I agree. It definitely there's been a lot more
legacy systems are hanging around because they can connect.
Yes.
To the new clusters.
Correct. And as we all know, with migrations, to kind of that first 95% feels simple, and that last 5% gets very, very difficult, right?
Right.
And that's where it ends up, you know, taking the bulk of your time, that last 5%, right? So getting intelligent, understanding the dependencies, and leveraging different tools to help with that, and being just smart, okay, which workload you need, which sequence, and so forth, right?
That's awesome. Yeah. So, Kelly, what are some of your goals in Google Cloud? What are you working on? You get your whole team there. What's your mission?
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting. I think there's the admittance of, like, there's no winner take all in the cloud space, and I think, you know, when we talk to enterprise customers, kind of putting them at ease, right, we're not here to say rip and replace, like that's a futile argument. So I think what we're focused on is kind of meeting customers where they are, and I think Nutanix, like on the journey to modernization, is part of that story, along with other, you know, partnerships. Yeah. Of course, AI I think is key. I think it's a very fluid landscape, and trying to stay on top of it. You know, in the ISV business that I run, it's interesting. I think, you know, last year it was kind of like, we got to build our own AI models, and now people are really walking away from that and saying, no, I don't have to do that. We're going to take advantage of Gemini and OpenAI and the best of breed models and kind of build their ecosystem around that. So I think that shift and that paradigm shift has been super eye-opening. Yeah. And so supporting people, you know, where they are, I think is critical to
hybrid.
The success.
And the hybrid. On-premise,
totally.
In the cloud.
Yeah, especially in enterprise, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, obviously seeing a lot of that. I'm wondering, when you think about the cloud clusters, if you're seeing any impact from, obviously, you know, the elephant in the room, some of the tariffs, things like that that are going on. Any shift to the cloud that organizations are doing from that perspective?
No, I think that's a great observation. So I think that when I think about that in general, maybe the headwinds and tariffs and other some of the things that are maybe the most recent ones, if you will. But I don't think it's any easier for organizations to think about modernization, migration, and the headwinds they're facing today than 5 years before, even before then. So when I think about things like AI is even putting a lot of pressure. Yeah. So tell me which CIO doesn't get pressure saying, hey, I need you yesterday leveraging AI and I need a 30% improvement in the workforce, or whatever that number may be, right? Or hey, I need to cut costs, but I still need you to deliver what we agreed to deliver, right? So I think in general, more so than ever, organizations are seeing a ton of pressure to do more with less, right? Now you have things like tariffs coming in, and for some special, you know, manufacturing and goods companies, that obviously introduces new complexities, right? So I think this is where customers are getting a ton of pressure saying, hey, how do I quickly modernize and be able to leverage AI, be able to leverage these latest and greatest services in them? And I do think a lot of those will come from hyperscalers like Google Cloud. So how do I get there, right? And then, so this is where I think it's the demand is just growing more and more for Nutanix Cloud Clusters to be able to help me ease along that journey, right?
Yeah,
right.
Michal, Kelly, yep. Thank you for coming on theCUBE here
at
Nutanix Next 2025, I almost said 24. Google Next was a couple weeks ago. Thanks for coming on. The ecosystem's growing, a lot of new action, a lot of more integrated partnerships, tightly coupled. Thanks for coming on, appreciate
thank
it.
Thank you for having
Thanks
us.
Thanks for having us.
All right,
cheers.
I'm John Furrier, yes, we are here at Nutanix Next with Bob Laliberte. Thanks for watching.